Hello everybody, my name is Greyboy, and welcome back to Minecraft Hunger Games. Now, I know I haven't been playing Minecraft for a while now, but yeah, today is a big day, yay! So yeah, let's get this show on a butter trucking road. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Temple. Prepare to be astonished. There you go. Gotta go fast. Now I haven't played Hunger Games in a while, so if I like die in the first 20 minutes, just. I told my dad that I was going to take my dog out for a walk while he went to work. So I did, but the one thing he didn't know is that I took my dog all the way out to GameStop, right? And considering that I didn't really have any hotspot on my phone at the time, because for some reason I lost a lot of memory for no apparent reason. I went all the way out there and try my best to keep try to keep a website on my phone, because I was using Bing and as long as I have the website on my phone, it won't like just cut off and just say unable to use this website anymore. So I kept it until my dog started running past me and past my pocket, and when my dog did that, he knocked my phone right out of my hand. Oh, right out of my pocket, because he like bumped into me. By the way, my dog name's Jack, and when he bumped into me, he knocked the phone out of my hand, right? I mean, out of my pocket. So when he did that, I lost my only way back home. So I just went out, and it took me around 5 hours to even find my neighborhood again. So when I found my neighborhood, I had to ask so many people concerned that my neighborhood was so big. I had to ask so many people, where's my address, and I could put it to their phones. They didn't even offer me tickets, they just showed me directions. Until one time I met this woman, I knocked on this woman's door, and I was walking near like the biggest lake in my neighborhood, and as I was walking by there, I just had to like jump over a gate, pick my dog up, and throw him over the gate. Not like forcefully though, I just like, he started to jump as I picked him up. So he went over the gate, I got over the gate, I had to knock on this woman's door, and then they called my dad, and then when they called, it took them another 30 to 45 minutes just to arrive there, and the police was there too, was with my dad, and at the same time, like, I'm gonna be honest, I was scared at the time, but I was more than scared, I was like freezing. I actually thought I was gonna like be a hobo out on the streets. I mean, I did have money, that was a good thing, but I was like stuck. I did not know where to go, don't know what to do besides try to stay alive, and my hand was numb. Like, it was like in the middle of, I think it was either December or January, like in the middle of those two. Like, it was like right, it was 5 days before my birthday. If some of you guys don't know what my birthday is, it's December 25th, the day of Christmas Eve. So yeah. Yeah, you know something about me, hooray. But anyway, moving on. I was stuck outside in the cold with nothing but a short sleeve shirt, because I didn't think I was going to be gone for so long. So I just put on just something, and I was just in some shorts and some short sleeve. Everywhere I go, people keep on asking me, "Are you cold?" I mean, it's like the cold. I just went honestly, yeah, I'm a bit chilly, but what's the worst that can happen? It's not like I'm going to be stuck here for 10 hours. And what do you know? I was. So, yeah. That's what happened to me when I nearly became a homeless hobo until my dad found me. But, yeah, I mean, it was scary. But, I mean, at least I met a lot of people. Like, a lot of good people. Like, people that could probably help me my journeys. So yeah, I'm really glad I had people like those. And if any of you people that did help me watching this video right now, thank you for your help for me to find back home so I can continue making these videos for my viewers. for my subscribers too. Like, I thank you guys so much for helping me back home. I mean, right now I feel very emotional right now, but I just don't know why I keep crying. Like, ever since I was 5, I just never was able to cry, even if I really wanted to. Yeah. But that's a story for another day. And lag.